image many Americans have of Nevada, the Las Vegas Strip, a glitzy playground for people with money to burn. But there's much more to Las Vegas and the state of Nevada. It was a sleepy western town back in the 1900s. The population grew slowly at first, fueled by mining and later by legalized gambling. But over the past two decades, Nevada's population has simply exploded, in large part because of a surge in Latino residents and other minorities. All sorts of folks are retiring and moving to Nevada as well. Our senior political analyst, Bill Schneider, is on the scene for us in Las Vegas. It's the backdrop for CNN's Democratic presidential debate Thursday night. All right, Bill, all of us have been to Vegas. What's new? What's going on there? What's new in Las Vegas? Everything, including the politics.
Las Vegas is a boomtown, literally. That is the Frontier Hotel coming down, the Las Vegas Strip's first themed casino. Went up in 1942, came down Tuesday morning, 2:30 a.m. They say what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, but not for long. This is a town where everything changes fast. Ask the congresswoman.
I've got the fastest growing congressional district in the United States with 1.9 million people. We have 5,000 new residents a month coming into town.
Who are all those people? They're young people with families taking new jobs in the booming service sector.
We build a school a month in order to keep up with the growth.
They're retirees.
I've got the fastest growing senior population.
Veterans.
I've got 212,000 veterans here in the Las Vegas Valley.
And Hispanics.
I've got the fastest growing Hispanic population.
You've heard how the American labor movement is struggling to survive? Not here.
The only community in the United States that has a growing union population.
The politics are changing too. Until the 1980s, Nevada tended to vote Democratic. It's the Silver State. William Jennings Bryan, the candidate of Free Silver, carried it three times. The population boom of the 1970s and 80s brought a lot of new voters, mostly white, mostly Reagan Republicans. Now with the new population boom, it's changing again.
We have recently flipped the state, and there are now more registered Democrats than Republicans in the state of Nevada.
Who's this we? Vegas, baby, Vegas.
70% of the state population is located here in southern Nevada. We've dramatically changed the state.
Now, with just 5 electoral votes, why is Nevada significant? Because it's a bellwether state. Nevada has voted for the winner in every presidential election since 1912, with one exception. That was 1976. What happens in Vegas may be about to happen everywhere. Well, good point. See you tomorrow. Thanks very much, Bill, for that. And this programming note, as I said, I'll be in Las Vegas to moderate Thursday night's debate. Our coverage of the debate begins at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific. 2 hours of Democratic presidential candidates Thursday night in Vegas. Jack Cafferty is watching all of this from Cafferty. Jack.
The town has changed a lot. When I was just a kid, my mother used to put my brother and me on a Greyhound bus in Reno, and we'd travel 440 miles across the desert to Las Vegas, where my Uncle Jack was the manager of the Golden Nugget Casino downtown on Fremont Street. The Strip was non-existent. There were 3 or 4 places out on the Strip. The population of the town was less than 100,000. It's unbelievable. The woman said there's 1.9 million people out there now. Amazing.